Hello, watchers. My name is H, and here is my first Uniden telephone since a EXP370 telephone that I had back in the early 2000s. So, kind of interesting. I haven't had one of these for a long time. But I'm glad to start out with a very common model that was sold very well and was very popular. This is the Uniden Dect 1560 with a DCX150 handset. Then I paid a whopping $1 for this, $1.01 to be exact, after application of sales tax. Did not come with an AC adapter, but who can complain for a dollar? Happen to have this one on hand. Voltage is unfortunately a little bit higher than this thing needs, but the amperage is also a little bit lower, and it's not high enough to blow it up or anything. So just for testing purposes, until I get another one of these with a more proper voltage, let's plug it in. And we'll wire this in here so that it does not come out. I believe it goes in this one. There we go. Do we have juice? We do have juice. Cradle looks to be quite dusty, which I guess is a good sign, because that probably means that this handset spent a lot of time not put on the base, and that probably means that the battery was treated properly. Speaking of battery, let's see what kind of battery we have in here. Some strange writing on there. Looks like it says change 'em. Some power symbol there in the 13. Maybe this was installed in 2013. Oh, we do have a fluorine. Two AA's cell type thing. It's a nickel metal hydride. 1800 milliamps. I have a feeling that's a little bit higher than the one that came in here, so that's going to provide for a nice long charge. I like that. The wire's kind of messed up here. Not quite sure what happened there, but it does fit. So make sure not to squeeze this too much and put this back on here. Unfortunately, there is some scratches and clouding on the screen and also some of these buttons, but hey, I still can't complain for a dollar. So let's go ahead and put that on there and we'll see if it comes to life. Okay, it looks like the telephone has come to life. And it says handset 2 on it, so I'm guessing this was a multi-handset system, or there were multiple handsets paired with it in the previous owner's setup. But that's okay. At least this one will work with it. And it's indicating that the battery is charging. So we'll get back to this once the battery has charged for a good amount of time, and we'll test it out. Alright, it's charged for a good amount of time, so let's proceed with the first look. First, I'll check all the buttons, because that impacts everything else I do. Look, it's already charged to 2/3. That's always cool. Hopefully that doesn't mean there's a problem with the battery, because it's only been charging for like 2 hours. Oh, there we go. Okay. Thought maybe the ketone was turned off. Alright, all the buttons do work. Yeah, let's see about the caller ID, see if there's anything in there. Okay, there are some things in there. October 4th, this seems to have been last used. Then September, and then February. Oh, unless they're deleting the caller IDs, this was not used a whole lot. There's nothing in the phone book. There are some redials. Nothing strange like there was in the other one. go ahead and clear those out before they show up on camera. Oh my gosh, you have to go through 3 steps just to delete it. You can't just hit clear. That's kind of ridiculous. Alright, redials are empty. Delete all the caller IDs. There we go. Let's check out some of the ringtones. I'm pretty sure I know which ones are on here. What in the world? The screen is flickering. Or the backlight, rather. It's probably not showing up on camera whatsoever, but it is flickering a little bit. Yep, it's got all the standard ringtones. I'll go ahead and put that on the clatter for now. And let's make sure auto talk is off. It is. Date and time. Global setup. So we got handset set up. Alright, that's about it. And unfortunately, it looks like there's a little bit of LCD damage and possibly like a burnt pixel up there. But that's alright, it's still perfectly readable. Alright, so without further ado, let's connect the phone line and we'll test the calling. Okay, the check tell line has gone away. It's definitely a vibration thing going on.
Good evening. Putting knowledge and experience to work to help businesses succeed. People's United Bank, N.A., member FDIC. Today is Friday, March 23rd. People's United Bank time, 11:40. Current temperature, 40 degrees.
Partly sunny today.
Okay, that seems to work just fine. So I think that's about all we can do with the first look. So join me in the next one, and we will get this thing refurbished. Thank you for watching.